here. I'm excited. I made it. Okay, here we go. We're starting about 1650 feet at the beginning, 21 degrees. It's great. I just met up with those same bunch of guys from Nova Scotia. They made it here as well. I'm glad I made it. I wasn't gonna come. I was just gonna wait for tomorrow. I didn't think I'd make it here in time, but I'm so glad. Waiting to do this ride forever. This is a bucket lister for me. Been watching so many guys on YouTube do this, especially the Cycle Fanatics guy. Been watching his YouTube rides on the mountain. Hoping my GoPro battery has enough life left in it. Maybe I'll shut it off for a bit until we get up a little higher. There's 2,000 feet.
So we're at about 34,000 feet, or sorry, 3,400 feet. 18 degrees, wind is picking up. Pretty smooth riding so far though. It is quite narrow, but it's not overly busy, which is good. And yeah, still quite a few trees, so I'm not getting a real great view yet, but I would say they're gonna start thinning out pretty soon. Yeah, it's hard to look at the view. The road's so thin, you really gotta pay attention. Great ride though. See you in a little bit.
It's just past a sign that said entering the Alpine zone. Just shy of 4,000 feet. Mile post. Yeah, a lot of bikes up here today, which is no surprise with Laconia bike. We go, wow, holy hit. Oh my goodness, that is so disorientating. 4,000 feet. Wow. That is something. Yeah, the trees drop off pretty quick. Wow. I'm not gonna stop yet. I wanted to stop and have a look, but I'm gonna keep on going. Well, the going's good, because the weather can change here so quick. I think I'm just gonna go straight to the top and see what I can see up top, and then if I want to, I'll stop off at maybe some look-offs on the way down. But wow, I mean, it's just amazing. Thank you. Yeah, they're not kidding when they say this ride is no joke.
Degrees. Pavement's rough in places, but not too bad. It's certainly manageable. I still have the bike all loaded up. I didn't stop and drop off my gear at the campsite because I didn't know if I'd have enough time. It's nice smooth stuff here. A lot of this road washed out or so ago. Wow, look at that. Cloud just blowing up over the mountain. Might not be anything to see up here. We're up in the clouds now. Over 5,800 feet, and you can't see anything. Tense at the top in these conditions.
the guys had their four-way flashers on. It's really, really difficult to see. I'm here. Yeah, that was an experience, and I guess I'm not done yet. It's quite an intense ride once you get up that last mile. You cannot take your eyes off the road to look around. It is just not worth it. The split second you look around, the road's just so narrow and you get so disorientated so quickly. Oh, at least get a bit of visibility now. It's not too bad when you can see. It's once you're up in the clouds. Oh yeah, just that wind just shoves you. Before you know it, you're wide on a turn. I don't know if the GoPro shows how much fast that cloud is moving. Say, I think I would rather do it on a motorcycle than a car. And if you were in a car, you definitely want to have a... You definitely want to have a manual transmission. There's a lot of brakes burnt up on this ride. 1,000 feet. Yeah, this guy's gonna burn his brakes up here. Jesus. I gotta get out of this mess. There. Just under 4,000 feet now, up to 15 degrees. Back into the trees. really is a great ride. It's a bit intense at the top, and especially when you're in the clouds, the fog like that, the visibility was next to nothing. That was a bit intense, but even towards the top before I lost visibility, for me anyway, I'm not used to being around higher elevations. And I know some people are saying, you know, especially from they're around the Rockies and stuff like that, saying, you know, that's not really high elevations. But I mean, like I said, I'm rarely above sea level. So, you know, over 6,000 feet, I think it's 6,200 and some odd feet or whatever it is, you know, looking around with drop-offs like that, it's, you know, Nova Scotia isn't the prairies. There are some hills, but, you know, I'm not used to just that scope of openness with that type of mountainous or terrain around that elevation. So it's a bit disorientating, especially when you're riding a motorcycle up it. But I wouldn't say it's scary, it's just you just gotta pay attention, that's all. But this ride was a bucket list for me. I've wanted to do it for a while. And then especially, like I said, after watching a couple of YouTube videos by, I think it was guy's channel, Cycle Fanatics. Guy puts out a lot of, he's a Harley guy. But he puts out a lot of fun, he does a lot of fun rides and stuff like that. He's a great personality. And he did some, I think he did a few really, really good rides, or YouTube videos on this ride, so I've been wanting to do this, so check that off the old bucket list.
And that was it. Washington Auto Road.
Worth doing. Could be a little intense, but well worth doing.